Hi everybody, today we are going to talk about saving face. It's a cultural concept present in daily life in some Asian countries as well as in some European countries. Wait, what? Yes, maybe you've heard that saving face is a concept from China or from Japan and that it exists only there, but that's wrong. First of all, what does saving face mean exactly for the Eastern world? Well, let's say that we are going out with our life partner and his or her colleagues. At certain point, your partner makes an awkward joke, which you don't really like that much, and normally your answer would just be like, you idiot, if you were alone. But since in this case you are with the colleagues, who are actually waiting for your reaction to start laughing like crazy, either in front or in the back or behind the back of your partner, to save his face, you will choose to keep a neutral smile without saying something that could hurt your partner in that moment, instead of causing a scene. This is what we say when you try to save the face for someone. So, here we can see that the so-called face is just the image that a person wants to give to others, and it is pretty normal that people always want everybody else to see the good image of them and don't want other people to destroy this image if they can. In China and also in other Eastern Asian cultures, this is extremely important. Saving the face of other people is like good manners. Let's make another example in the business world. I'm having a conversation with a business partner and his colleagues get in the room for a short amount of time. As I'm the technical consultant, we are discussing the features of the product, let's say a business card holder. When my business partner say to make the business card holder thin to the point it can hold only one card per time, almost anybody would think it's a joke, but he's dead serious. I can see his colleagues will get ready for my reaction. Perhaps smiling already. Maybe I would think, I cannot let those people think I'm an idiot and I don't understand this mistake, I must point it out. But in that case, I will completely embarrass my business partner in front of his peers, and my business partner in the end is the most and only important person for me in the entire room. A saving face reaction instead would be to attempt de-escalation by changing the topic, saying something like, okay, we'll discuss this topic later as I would like to think about it a little bit more. Or, I see your point, do you mind if I express my view as well? Or make a very indirect statement about it, such as, different opinions are precious. The kind of saving face like this usually happens offline, or in the case when people know who you are. On the internet, it's much more different, and bashing people online is not so uncommon. But internet is still a separate environment if we compare it with public life. In East Asia, conflict should be avoided at all times, and when not possible, it is not considered polite to embarrass people in public, where public means people that are not in a close relationship with both of you. For this reason, private conversation is the only condition in which you can be direct to somebody, even if it is a family member or a close friend. But what happens then? Well, usually Chinese will try to use a fairly indirect criticism or sentence, perhaps even a metaphor, to convey the message to the person that should receive it without directly embarrassing that person. For example, in the example before, as I believe a business card holder should be light as well as able to hold a few cards, so you won't need to carry more than one, the best number, in my opinion, is 20 cards. Perhaps saying something that only the person who have made the mistake can get or that can save the person from the embarrassing situation. For example, always in the example before, the boss is wise, he made a very good point, letting only one person in the business card holder because we need to get only the decision makers, which usually are really one or two. The rest are always useless contacts. Also, one important point is being indirect in the phrasing, using metaphors, for example. If you pay attention to how Chinese diplomatic staff will answer some controversial questions, you really get the point. When the diplomatic of China, Hua Chunying, was asked by a journalist, the women who enter the President Trump's Mar-a-Lago property without permission, do they work for the Chinese government? Usually this kind of question will get an answer like no comment, or that's absolutely false, or much more likely get ignored. Hua Chunying instead answered, "Certain people in the US are wasting their talent not writing science fiction or making sci-fi movies." Now, we are not going to discuss the political outcome of this answer, just take it as an example how Chinese talk by one of the public speakers of the country. Although it's a complex situation, it's far from being a unique thing of East Asia. While Japanese try to avoid conflict even more than Chinese, we found the same behavior pretty close to a concept present in Italy. In Italy, we have something called avoiding to lose face, which is basically a similar thing. This is what we would say when in presence of people that we don't have too much confidence with. We avoid to say something out of context or embarrassing that can put us in a shameful situation. As Chinese culture pays more attention than Western culture on collectivism, it is fairly understandable that Chinese will give more importance to this concept than, for example, individualistic cultures in the West, such as the American culture. But it does not mean that it is a typical Chinese thing. The direct translation of losing face also exists in Italian. We say perdere la faccia. When somebody gets blamed in the presence of his or her peers, that's what we say. Italians appreciate much more to be scolded in private, because usually they have no chance or strength to answer back while being scolded in public. Perdere la faccia also is opposed to salvare la faccia, saving face. Both terms are widely used in Italy, while in English they are not as common. Probably this is one of the many contrasts between North Europeans and the South Europeans, as the value of face is not as important in mainstream Western cultures such as the English and consequently the American. The concept of saving face and avoiding embarrassment existed for a long time. In both my mother culture and my adopted culture, bashing people in public is not considered virtuous, no matter how good you can be at it. The real virtue is to be able to hold it and express your judgment and advice later on, when you are alone with the individual, or eventually use a metaphor that can be understood only by that single person in public. But the most important thing is to avoid escalation. In Italy we say dirty clothes are washed inside the family. It means try to let as less people as possible know about the issues of your close ones, solve them in private. It's really a very similar concept indeed. Perhaps the attitude will be different and Italians won't use metaphors or fairly indirect statements like Chinese, but it's really the same idea behind it. In my experience living in China as a foreigner, I always get asked more about there must be a lot of different things with your motherland. But I'm far more interested into the things that Italy and China have in common. After all, international cooperation can only happen when we find the similarities among apparently very different cultures, and that's what I like to focus on. So, for today this is all. If you have any feedback, please let us know, and share this content if you think it can be useful. Till next time, bye bye!